Now I've got him where I want him. Not at all. This is a terrible position in jiu-jitsu. He's got what's called a crossface. So he's coming under my head and he's driving my face this way with his shoulder. So I'm looking this way. His other hand's coming under my arm with an underhook, which cuts down my ability to get an underhook. He can drop his head and put a tremendous amount of weight on me. This sucks. It hurts my neck. And it also means that I'm pointing this way. Most half guard attacks involve me facing my opponent like this. By using my head and by making me look this way, by stapling my face to the ground this way, I'm not facing him. So how do you get out of here? How do you get out of that terrible position? I'm gonna show you three ways to get out of it. Basically, you want your back to this, Richie? If I've got Richie in the crossface with the underhook here and the crossface and driving, he can take me this way, or that way. He can take me to his, that's your left. He can take me to his left, he can take me up, he can take me to his right. So let's go through these one by one. I use these all the time. The first one, I call this the kamikaze. We're here, he's not gonna pressure my face too much. This is if he's got the full on crossface really turning my head, I can't really do this too effectively. So this is if it's tight, but not super crazy tight. Step one, grab the shoulder, pull this out as much as I can. If he's driving his whole weight of his body, my ability to pull down and row with my arm and maintain a grip on his delt, that's gonna be not that effective, but it's better than nothing. So this is one. Two, for step two, I'm gonna move my feet a little bit to the outside. See my feet here? I'm gonna move them this way. Step three, I do three things at once. I'm going to chop down here to block his leg. I'm gonna swing this arm up and club him at the top of the head. I don't hit him in the neck, I hit him at the top of the head, and I'm gonna bridge. So one, two, three, bridge. So one, give myself a bit of room. Two, move my feet to the outside a bit. This is so that I can bridge this way. Three is three things at the same time. One, two, bridge. I'm not bridging straight up, I'm bridging towards you guys, sideways. I'm also not clubbing him in the neck. This isn't pro wrestling. I'm trying to do it higher on the head. Why? Because that way I can lead his head and steer him over this way, right? I get some additional force because I can bend the head here. So there, the kamikaze. That's the aggressive option. Let's say I don't quite have the position. He's wary of it, his weight's a little bit this way, and I don't think I can get it. The best I can hope for is to use this to make a little bit of room to bring this hand back in front and this hand onto the bicep. Now, depending what kind of guard I want to use, I can bring the other knee in, I can re-guard. So I'm using the sweep just to move his body sideways. Not to sweep him, just to take their shoulder off my neck. So one, two, three. If I create a bit of room, depending on the exact configuration, either bring this hand onto the bicep first, or I bring this across the neck first. But at the end of it, I want here and here. Skate my hips out, maybe put my knee in, maybe bring my knee up for the shell. But I've gotten out of that terrible crossface position. Next version, that was taking him to the right. Next version, I'm gonna take him up. Come this way, please. What I'm going to do, this is the hardest part of this technique somehow, sometimes. I'm going to put this foot under his thigh here as a hook. This can be tough. Drop that knee to the ground, please, Richie. If you're not real flexible, this can be tough. I can do two things to make that a bit easier. Number one, move my hips to the outside a bit. And two, grab my own foot and stuff it in. Drop that knee a bit. If I move my hips to the outside, I put my foot on the ground and then roll my leg so that that comes onto my instep. Or two, I move my hips to the outside, grab my own leg, jam it in. That's step one. Step two, this hand is gonna go on the hip, and then step three, I'm gonna plant this foot on the ground, lift, lift, and bridge. There. Drop them in to the butterfly guard and sit up. Let's show that from the other angle, please. So we're here. Go ahead, crush me. I'm gonna do this mostly if his weight's really high. If his weight is back a bit, well then this isn't a problem. I'm not suffering from the crossface. I have other half guard problems, but I'm not gonna try this lift. His weight really needs to be driving up. He's like trying to pop the head off a daisy here with his shoulder. So pull this down, get a little bit of breathing space. Insert this hook, either by escaping my hip, putting that foot on the ground, and then rolling him over top of it, or escaping my hip, taking my hand, shoving my leg in there. Step two, I'm going to abandon this, put it on the hip, and then I'm going to plant this foot here, and I'm gonna bridge off of there. This isn't as hard as you think it is. I'm gonna insert my butterfly hook here. I don't wanna let him come back down here. This is a great position for him to start passing the guard again. So, when I've got him in the air, I'm gonna drop him towards the ground and then kick him away. So, I lift him up, but I don't just drop him down. I lift him up, I drop him down towards the floor, and then throw him away. If I wanna get really fancy, and I really wanna go for it, drive up, please, Richie. We're here, I put that hook in, I lift, and I go to a sweep. I'm going to, instead of inserting the butterfly hook here, I'm going to chop with that leg. So one more time, the more aggressive option. First, take some pressure off the throat. I've gotta get him to drive up into me for this. So if I pull down, most guys will respond by pushing harder. That's great, actually, for this. Two, this hook goes in. Three, hand on the hip. And then four, post and lift. But now my foot that's on the floor, instead of coming into a butterfly hook, comes to the outside and goes down. And with some luck, I'll get to the top. Unlikely to work against somebody really good, but worth going for, because it'll freak them out. And in the resultant motion, you're probably off of that position. The third option, we've taken them to the right, we've taken them straight up, we'll take them to the left. So we're here. Maybe, I think he's too heavy to lift. Maybe his weight's too far this way for the kamikaze sweep to work. I'm gonna go to the twist sweep, and that's to take him this way. So the conservative and the aggressive version of the twist sweep are pretty similar. I'm going to put both of my feet as tight as I can to Richie's right knee. Here, I'm gonna bridge ever so slightly, really just to take my ass off the ground, and then I'm gonna take my knees, which are pointing this way, and point them that way, here. So we're here, move the feet, clamp the arm, because I don't want him to post, and then bridge a little bit, and point my knees this way. Obviously, if I come to the top, that's fantastic. Let's say I can't come to the top. Let's say he releases and posts his foot, posts his hand. Let's say I can't make it to the top. Let's say he releases and posts with his hand, or just has got such great balance that this isn't gonna work. We're here, there. That then allows this hand to come back in, push across the throat, and get this hand off of my neck. Escape in to the scissor half guard, to half guard shell, or reset to the guard. From the other side, we're here. Ugh, I was driving in, take some weight off. My feet come to the outside of Richie's knee. I'm gonna clamp here. I'm gonna lift a little bit and point my knees towards you guys. This hand can help a bit here. It's hard for it to do much. Let's say he recovers or he posts his head. That should give me enough room to get this hand in, which should give me enough room to get that arm in. Allows me to bring my other leg in somehow and get back to guard. Now think about it. You're there, you're pinned flat. You can take them to the right, you can take them to the left, or you can lift them, and you can combine these. You can try the kamikaze sweep and go into the twist sweep. You can do the twist sweep and go into the kamikaze sweep. We're here, I'm trapped. We're here, he's heavy. He's got his weight perfectly set. I try and kamikazeing him, he drives back in. I twist sweep him. I try twist sweeping him, it doesn't move. I kamikaze him. The only caveat there is you don't want to stay bridge. You don't want to kamikaze with your hips elevated and then try and turn here. That's not going to work. You're going to kamikaze, elevate your hips, drop your hips, and then twist sweep. Or twist sweep, drop your hips, and then kamikaze. That wild bridging left and right with the technical details of blocking the things that he can post with should either get you back to the top or allow you to get your hands back into position to get his grips off your head and reestablish a half decent half guard.